In this lecture, I will show you how to simulate the field around a microstrip in 3D. Many engineers know this two-dimensional demonstration on how the field lines extend around a microstrip, but often it is hard to convert this 2D image into a three-dimensional one inside your mind. For example, in the 3D view, you will be easily able to grasp how the field is very weak in the center of the bottom side of the PCB. But how the field is stronger on the edges of the PCB. If you place a component on the bottom corners of the PCB, there might be cases where your component isn't all that happy with the interfering fields. Electromagnetic compatibility engineers will also always tell you that the energy is in the fields and not in the traces. As you see in this demonstration, this is of course correct. But have you realized that most of the energy of a strip line is right around the trace and not exactly in between the trace and the ground plane? And interestingly, placing a trace here, right in between the traces and the ground plane, could be a better position than placing it above the trace. Just imagine placing a trace here. It will be coupled very strongly to the ground below it, and also the upper trace will have a lot of ground around this specific trace to be connected to. The three-dimensional view also shows you that in order to truly shield the electric fields of the trace, it does not help too much to have a ground plane under the signal. Especially with a two-layer board like this one. The ground plane is 1.6 millimeters away from the trace, and this is simply too far away in order to contain the fields. In the other lectures, we will have a look at the trace like this one, which is also shielded by two grounds on the left and the right of the trace, which will contain the fields much better than in this case. Let's now start our simulation process. Start Salome. Switch to the geometry editor. Add a box which will be our trace and set the following sizes. Let's move into the center of our coordinate. Add a ground plane with the following sizes. Move it into the center. Now add a sphere. This will be used as our boundary. Mark the trace, ground plane and the sphere, so three solids in total, and create a partition out of them. Now export the partition. Go to the mesh editor. Mark the partition and click on create mesh. Now click here, here, here and here. Change the settings as I did. Click OK and apply and close. Now run the mesh generation with this button. The meshing will now take some time. If your laptop is slow, this can take several hours. There should be no warnings and errors. Close the success window. By default, all the surfaces are summarized into just one selectable face. We will need to be able to select specific faces of the bodies later, hence split the faces into their single surfaces by using this button. Mark the mesh and export it as an UNF file. Now close Salome. If you want, you can save the Salome project. Open Elmer. Load the mesh. Create an equation. Apply it to all bodies and activate it. now set the material of all bodies to air, you might think that the trace and ground plane are copper. Yes, that's true, but I will only set the surfaces of the parts to a potential. The fields will extend from the surfaces only, so we can ignore that there is copper underneath. Add the first boundary, which is the infinity BC, or infinity boundary condition. It is applied only to the sphere surface. Now add a boundary to the trace. I will just click through the boundaries until all six surfaces of our track are marked in red. To see all the sides, I will just rotate the view. Run the simulation. Once the simulation is done, view the results in Elmer VTK. Select isosurfaces. In order to see inside the field, you can either use the clip plane tool or adjust the opacity. We are now finished with this lecture. You can close Elmer.